والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. So we are, alhamdulillah, on the last page of our course. We are studying five pages in this course, which are the first five pages of Juz 1. And you can also first five pages call, you can also call them as first five pages of Surah Al-Baqarah. So we started with Al-Fatiha asking for guidance, and Al-Baqarah started with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declaring that the guidance is for muttaqeen and not for kafirin, not for munafiqeen. And then Allah gave the da'wah of the Quran, and now starts the story of Adam alayhi salam, who was the first person to be guided. All right, so we can, you know, I hope you have memorized by this, you know, we have repeating them so many times, and how beautiful this feeling is that you can say that I know the contents of Surah Al-Baqarah just on my fingertips, I mean the first five pages. That's great. And in fact, alhamdulillah, I did it for whole Baqarah. You can do that also. So praise and guidance, praise and prayer, dua for guidance and guidance for muttaqeen, and the attributes of muttaqeen, and not for kafirin, not for munafiqeen, because they are corrupt and double-faced. And first example and the second example, Quran's call, Quran's challenge, Quran's warning, Quran's examples, who gets misguided, and how can you disbelieve? And then we have Adam alayhi salam. And to remember these, this page is extremely easy. This is, you know, kind of rhyming. Sajda, sorry, Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Can you repeat five times? Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Last time, Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. I hope now you have memorized the contents of this page. So we are talking of Khalifa. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in previous verses talked about the guidance, and now he says the guidance has been given right from the beginning. So Islam is very clear and a simple, it gives a coherent, you know, not like what happened, for example, in Christianity before Jesus alayhi salam, or what happened before Musa alayhi salam. No, it doesn't work like this. From the first time, first man was guided, okay? So it talks about the beginning of creation also. So Allah says that he will make Adam Khalifa on the earth. Allah did not get angry with angels' questions. A question, Allah already knew that there will be bloodshed on the earth, and he knows everything, including the good works that will be done by people. So let us start. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. And when your Lord said to the angels, indeed I will make upon the earth a successive authority. وَإِذْ قَالَ, what means and, إِذْ and. Sorry, إِذْ means when. وَإِذْ and when, قَالَ said, قَالَ رَبُّكَ, your Lord said, your Rabb said. Very simple, all words are known to you actually. Lil malaika, to angels. To the angels, inni, indeed I, innahu, indeed he, innahu, innahum, innaka, inni, innakum, innana. So inni, indeed I, ja'ilun. Ja'ala, yaj'alu, yaj'al, ja'il. Ja'il, the one who makes, the maker, okay, will make, will place. Fil ardi, in the earth. We told you, in English, we have to say upon the earth, on the earth. Khalifa, a successive authority, the one who comes after the other. Then the angel said, قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ. They said, will you place upon it one who causes corruption therein and sheds blood? قَالُوا, they said, أَتَجْعَلُ, will you place, will you make, فِيهَا, in it, فِي الْأَرْضِ فِيهَا. Ha, why ha? Because earth is feminine, mu'annas in Arabic language, okay? Earth is feminine. I think it is feminine in English also. So are you going to place on it? Man yufsidu fiha. Man means who? Yufsidu causes corruption. It is from mufsidun, and you will learn, inshallah, in third course, afsada yufsidu, the derived forms. So man yufsidu fiha, the one who will spread corruption, who will cause corruption in it, okay, on the earth. Wa yasfiku. Yasfiku means and sheds ad-dima, blood. Wa yasfiku ad-dima, and sheds blood. So the angels asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are you going to place on earth someone who will spread corruption and shed blood? وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. And we glorify with your praises and we sanctify you. Wa means, you know, wa means and, but wa has different meanings in this context. Wa means why, okay? And it is there in English also. For example, if I ask someone to be serious, and he's supposed laughing, so we'll say, I'm telling you and you're still laughing, meaning while you are doing this. I mean, I'm telling you to be serious and you, while you are laughing. So wa means while, nahnu, so remember wa also means while, nahnu, we, nusabbihu, we glorify, sorry, nusabbihu, and this is also advanced forms, sabbaha yusabbihu, and you will learn it in next course, so don't leave next course. Nusabbihu, yufsidu, all these are nuqaddisu, these are derived forms, and derived forms occur one in every line of the Quran, just like weak verbs. So here you see, we have three lines and three words, yufsidu, nusabbihu, nuqaddisu. On the average, you get one derived form in every line of the Quran. They are very, very easy. They are called mazid fi and they will become laziz fi. Laziz means tasty. Okay, as my friend said it. So inshallah, they will be very easy. Don't leave the second course. Make sure that you continue this journey. So every line, one word in every line of the Quran will be clear in addition to so many other good things that you will learn. So while we glorify, وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ, with your praises, وَنُقَدِّسُ, and we sanctify, تَقْدِيس, okay, وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ, and we declare that, O Allah, you are pure, you are sacred, so, and we sanctify you. قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. قَالَ, he said, إِنِّي, indeed I, أَعْلَمُ, I know, or I know, a'lamu, ma la ta'lamun, that which you don't know. All right. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that he will make Khalifa on the earth. We are here on the earth as per the plan of Allah and not because Adam alayhi salam ate the fruit or did the mistake. Now many people said, oh, if Adam alayhi salam had not eaten the fruit, we would not have been here. That's nonsense, actually, because Allah says, he had planned it anyway. This declaration is before Adam alayhi salam ate the fruit. So Khalifa has two meanings. The one who implements the orders, okay, and the one who comes after the others. Allah led the, قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَا. So Allah led the angels ask the question. SubhanAllah, he did not get angry. So we should answer questions if someone needs to know. And if we know the answer, we should give the answer. Actually, why did angels ask? They were not objecting. Actually, they were shocked to know that human beings will be given power and they will commit bloodshed, and that such a thing will happen in Allah's world. Therefore, they asked the question not as an objection, but to know the wisdom behind the creation of human beings. And of So they were so much worried about this, you know, this thing, because Allah's world, you know, before this was pure, and nothing was happening against Allah's will. And when they heard that human beings will do such a thing in Allah's world, where the angels are continuously doing tasbih and obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and nothing in this world, you know, does anything against Allah's will. So they were shocked and they asked this question. Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu reported the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked as to which words are the best. He said, those for which Allah made a choice for his angels and his servants, and the words are subhanallah bihamdi. And the angels, that's why in the same question said, وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ, while we glorify with your praises and we sanctify you, we do tasbih. So why do you need any other creation? Kind of, I mean, what's the wisdom? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. But this angels do tasbih and hamd, so that shows the importance of tasbih and hamd. And also, you know the hadith that there are two words to very light in the on the tongue, heavy in the scales, beloved to Ar-Rahman, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. And there are many, many there are other hadiths which are also giving the huge rewards for saying Subhanallah, for example, 100 times and so on. So tasbih and hamd are best forms of dhikr. Tasbih is to declare that Allah is free from defects. Everything he says has no doubt. That is tasbih. Actually, I always show it like with this my hand and say tasbih is negation of negatives and hamd is attributing positives. And you join both, that is tasbih and hamd. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. Okay. Qala inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun. And they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I know what you don't know, because Allah knew that there will be good people also on this earth and who will do wonderful works. May Allah make us among them. So we can pray to Allah, oh Allah, protect us from corruption, help us spread peace on the earth, help us spread your message, help us do your tasbih and hamd. And then we can plan. And also, in order to spread peace and avoid corruption, I will try to be an active social worker to spread peace and goodness. So Islam doesn't mean just you go to masjid and pray five times prayer and come back home and just recite Quran. No, 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 no. You have to be an active participant in the society and take a positive role, a constructive role. Don't sit down there and let all the corrupt people, you know, spread corruption in the earth. You have to stand up and be an active social worker. All right, so let us take Asma. Malak is Malaika, plural, and Khalifa, plural, is Khalaif, and Dam, plural, is Dima. And the verbs are, so can you give me the plurals, please? Malak, Malaika, Khalifa, Khalaif, Dam, Dima. Okay, let's take the words, the verbs now, or the words made up from verbs, like Ja'il. It's not a verb. It is a noun, but it is made from a verb. So can you show me the TPI sign? Three steps, okay? You have to show the TPI sign and show this form, the main key, fi'il madi, singular, muzakkar, and then give me the six forms. These are the three steps. If you are able to, you know, give these three steps, then you know all the occurrences of this verb or this the verb that comes from this word, okay? So Ja'il, show me Ja'il. Ja'il, the one who makes. Okay. So what is he made? So I will ask you English for this form. So you have to tell me the Arabic. I said Ja'il is the maker. So what is he made? Ja'ala. And give me the six keys. Ja'ala, yaj'al. Repeat. Ja'ala, yaj'alu. Ija'al. Ja'ala, yaj'alu. Ija'al. Ja'il, maj'ul, ja'al. Ja'il, maj'ul, ja'al. So now, once you know the six keys, then you know all the words of the that may occur in the Quran from any of these, because not every form may occur, but now you know the key. All right. Yes, Fiku. Yes, Fiku. Show the TPI sign. Yes, Fiku. He sheds or he will shed. Yes, Fiku. So what is he shed? Safaka. And it is associated with blood in general. So Safaka and yes, Fiku. So repeat after me. Safaka yasfiku isfik. Safaka yasfiku isfik. Safik masfuk safk. Safik masfuk safk. A'lamu. A'lamu, I know. Okay. So what is he knew? Alima. Repeat. Alima ya'lamu. I'lam.
Alima ya'lamu.
I'lam. Alim ma'lum ilm.
Alim ma'lum ilm.
As far as weak verbs are concerned, we have qala, which you know. Qala yaqulu qul qa'il maqul qawl. Can you repeat? Qala yaqulu qul.
Qala yaqulu qul
qa'il maqul qawl.
Qa'il maqul qawl.
Now let us start Kahoot. Be ready to enter the number. All right, number is 926647. 926-647. And I hope you have watched the lesson before coming here. Please do watch the lesson. Instead of doing it after, do it before. You have to watch, you have to do the homework anyway. And if you do it before, you will really benefit from the class and will be able to do much better than otherwise. Okay. So I'm ready with my notebook also.
Doctor, there's one question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Where the angel told the man will shed blood, so they expressed shock.
Okay. According to the scholars, when this was declared among the angels, or it was known, there may be a gap between the declaration, okay, number one, and this questioning, okay. And also that according to Mufsirin, the Adam alayhi salam's shape was put up there, and the angels started coming to know about him, and some of the features, especially that he will be given freedom. Now, Quran doesn't mention every detail. It mentions only those parts which are relevant to our, learning. So, it's not step-by-step description of everything that has happened. So let us, understand that those details are not given here, but somehow it was given to them directly or indirectly. And that's why they asked this question. All right, at this point, let me just start the quiz 926-647, and we talk more. Okay, ataj'alu, translate. Ataj'alu, ataj'alu fiha man yufsid. Will you place? Will he place? Will I place? Will they place? Allah says, ataj'alu fiha man yufsidu fiha. Okay, ataj'alu means will you place. Ataj'alu means will you place. And let us see, so many people are still confused. Taj'alu means you. Okay, come on, please. This pen is very inefficient. So let me just explain the other part. So ataj'alu means will you place. Now we have will he place? 15 people saying, will he place? Why? He means yaj'alu. Yasir yaj'alu. Yasir yaj'alu, yasirun yaj'alu. Tawfiq, are you sitting, make your friend sit in front of you and tell him, Tawfiq taj'alu. Tawfiq, you Tawfiq taj'alu. You make. Taj'alu. Taj'alu means you make. Okay. Will I place? This will be aj'alu. Aj'alu. A here is not part of the verb. It's not. So a means question mark. Okay. Taj'alu, you place. So ataj'alu means will you place. Ataj'alu, will you place. Ataj'alu fiha man yufsidu fiha. Okay. Let's go to the next question now. Translate. Wayasfiku. Wayasfiku. Don't miss wa. So and is there in all answer. We will shed, you will shed, he will shed, they will shed. Why as fiku? Why as fiku? Wow, there is so much confusion. Why as fiku dima? And he will shed. See again, ya means he will shed. Why is there confusion? I don't know. Your screen sharing is paused. Maybe that's why. Sorry. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Okay. So we'll skip this question. Wayasfiku, and he will shed. Let us go to the next one. Why is screen sharing paused? Okay. وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ. Now translate. وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ. While we glorified, while we glorify, while they glorify, why? While you all glorify. While we glorify. What means why? I mean in the sentence. Otherwise, if you just take wa, it will be and. So while nahnu, we nusabbihu, we glorify. While we glorify. While we glorified. Glorified is past tense. That is sabbahna. That we will take later on. Sabbahna. All right. So let us go to the next one now. وَنُقَدِّسُ And you sanctify, they or we, and we sanctify. Who is doing that? نُقَدِّسُ وَنُقَدِّسُ وَنُقَدِّسُ And we sanctify. نُقَدِّسُ Okay, and this is an advanced form. نُقَدِّسُ نُسَبِّحُ نُسْلِمُ نُسْفِكُ Whatever. All right. Let's take the next one now. فعل أمر of the verb جعل. جعل is here. So what will be this one? جعل يجعل. What is this? Is it إجعل إجعل لا تجعل or جعل? So now you must be familiar with the structure of ja'ala. Ij'al. Ij'al. Taj'alu. And I always say, please take the yaj'alu, for example, yaj'alu. And take this jim out. I'm sorry, ya out. So what are you remaining with? Ij'al. So just add a temporary e. Ij'al. Sorry, with this leaking pen. I could not fix it anyway. So, ataj'alu, sorry, ja'ala yaj'alu, cut that ya and it will be ja'al, put a temporary e, ij'al. So, it cannot be ij'il, okay? Because if you cut yaj'alu, so you remain with ja'al, al, not il. So, this one defines the fa'al amr. Remember again, this one defines, and you will say, how will I know this one? Well, because you are now reading this. So for example, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا. Okay, so تَجْعَلُ is there. Present tense, you already know. تَجْعَلُ يَجْعَلُ. And therefore, you should be able to make إِجْعَلُ. All right, let's go to the next one now. And this is فِعْل أَمْر. أَمْر means order. جَاعِل is not an order. جَاعِل means the one who makes. Okay, next one we have ism fa'il of qala. So qala, so like fa'il. What is for qala? Qala yaqulu qul. And what is this? Is it maqul qala naqulu qa'il? Ism fa'il means the one, the name of the one who does. Ism fa'il, the name of the doer. So qala means he said. So what will be the name for sayer? Sayer. Or the one who says is qa'il, fa'il, qa'il, okay, qa'il. Maqul is the one who said it, that which is said. Sorry, maqul, that which is said it, that which is said. That which is said is maqul, qa'il, the one who says. That which is said is maqul, and its feminine is maqula, and that's what we have in Urdu language. This is maqula of so and so, mashhur maqula. So maqalat, maqalat is something else, but maqul, maqula. Anyway, maqul is that which is said, and qa'il, the one who says. All right, let's go to the next one now. Plural of malakun, malakun. Is it malakun, malaika, maluk, muluk, or amlak? plural of malak. It's not malakun. Okay, it is malaika. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَ. We just saw it. Saw it. Muluk is the plural of anybody? Plural of malik. Malik means king. Okay, malik means king. And muluk means kings. And it is there in the Quran. Amlak is plural of milk. Milk means ownership of something. So amlak means properties. All right, amlak. But I don't think it's there in the Quran. Allahu a'lam. Okay. One of the two meanings of Khalifa is, one of the meaning is, who comes after others, slave of Allah, prophet of Allah, worshipper. It means the one who comes after others. Slave of Allah is Abdullah. It's not me. Khalifa has two meanings. The one who implements the orders and the one who comes after the other. Okay. So some people say there were jinns and then Adam alayhi salam, the human beings came after them or who, whatever. But we are like the earth was there and somebody was there or something was there or some people or some creations were there and we are replacing them or coming after them. So the one who comes after the others, and the other meaning is the one who implements the orders, not the slave of Allah, not the prophet of Allah, and not the worshipper. He can be of these, but the meaning, we are talking about meanings. If I say, can Khalifa be a slave of Allah? Yeah, of course. Can Khalifa be a prophet of Allah? Yes, he can be. Can Khalifa be a worshipper? Yes, he can be. But the meaning of Khalifa is the one who comes after the others or the one who implements. Tasbih is to declare that Allah is free from defects, is greatest, is one, is kind. Tasbih is to declare, to say Subhanallah. Subhanallah means Allah is what? Allah is free from defects. Okay, and this is the most important part. And that's why, you know, Quran mentions tasbih a lot, a lot, a lot. And we as Muslims, and you have done the first course, and we told you a typical Muslim repeats tasbih more than anything else. Okay. Because three times in ruku', three times in sajda, three times in another sajda, nine times in every raka'ah, and if he prays, let's say 30 raka'ah, so 30 times 9 is 270, and if he says subhanallah after the salah also, before sleep also, that exceeds 500. That's a lot, a lot, a lot. Alhamdulillah. And the reason why we are made to do tasbih is because it is so important, because we have to remove any feeling that Allah needs a partner, so there's no chance of shirk. We have to know that whatever Allah says is perfect, whatever commands He gave is perfect, whatever taqdeer we have is perfect, whatever. So it generates enormous positive attitude also, and so on. I don't want to repeat that now, but tasbih is amazing, amazing thing. Last question. Allah said He will make dash Khalifa on the earth. Who is that? Is it jinns, angels, Adam, or earth? Very simple question. Allah said that He will make. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. Who was that? It was Adam عليه السلام and his generation. All right, so I stop here and let us see the toppers and let us be ready. So third position. Dr. Ismail and Sister Asma, and we have Sister Raksha, and then we have Sister Armina, Sister Samina, mashallah. Congratulations, and let us see some more people. View full report, new report, and a view. Ooh, the players. I say it so that I don't press another button. So here are other people receiving 90% and 30, 40, and 50. So Brother Harun, are you ready? Then you can start, inshallah.
اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله علانيته وسره فأهل أنت أن تحمد وأهل أنت أن تعبد وأنت على كل شيء قدير اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So continuing the grammar part, today we have the revision of قال, زاد, and شاء. So you have done all these, so we are just doing the revision. So this was our master table, and over here we covered all these forms, and we saw that the sound verbs are coming 9,000 times in the Quran, whereas the weak ones are also coming 9,000 times, which makes them one per each line. And similarly, the repeated ones are occurring twice on each page. So just to practice this whole rhythmic statements which are being developed for you to recall whatever you have done in course one and also course two. So it would be, if you open the Quran, Fataha, Allah will help you, Nasara. Otherwise you will be hit. Then the weak verbs, Allah will give, it's a promise. Wahaba wa'ada. In fact, he said he will give more. Qala zada. Therefore, pray to him for guidance. Da'a hada. And have good opinion. Otherwise, you will be lost. Dhanna dhalla. So, starting from qala. So qala, if you know the word qala, you can simply construct the whole madhi table. So it would be, just for the practice, you can do it with me. Qala, qalu, qulta, qultu, qultum, qulna. Similarly, for the mudari', the key, yaqulu, you can construct the remaining. Yaqulu, yaquluna, taqulu, أقول تقولون نقول. And then for the أمر قل قولوا لا تقل لا تقول. And finally the noun part قائل مقول قول. So you have this occurring in Surah Al-Ikhlas, then Surah Al-Nas, Surah Al-Falaq. You saw this قل قل say والله Ahad. Then similar pattern. So this qala is actually following the style of nasara. Nasara yansuru unsur nasir mansur nasr. So it's following the same style, but we would be referring to qala. So dhaqa is another word which means he tasted. So even you see the word is pointing out that it's something to do with taste. Dhaqa. So he tasted. So we'll do just the table now. Dhaqa yadhuqu dhuq. Dhaqa yadhuqu dhuq. You can repeat it after me. Dhaiq madhuq dhuq. Dhaiq madhuq dhuq. And we know that the reality where the word says kullu nafsin ذائقة الموت. Each and every soul has to taste this موت. So then we have the same following pattern word, تاب. He repented. تاب. And we had learned that once we would be having تاب إلى, so it means he repented. فتاب علي would be meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repentance. And this would be, inshallah, the last verse which you would be covering in this course. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. So let's practice this together. تَابَ يَتُوبُ تُبْ. تَابَ يَتُوبُ تُبْ. تَائِبْ دَاشْ تَوْبَ. تَائِبْ دَاشْ تَوْبَ. So similarly, we had practiced it a lot. Kana, the word kana. So it means he was. So it would be kana yakunu kun. Kana yakunu kun. Kain dash kaun. Kain dash kaun. And the words fa innama yakulu lahu. كن فيكون وإذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, once he plans to do anything, he only says to it, be and it is. كن فيكون. So similarly, we have the word قام. He stood. So let's do it. قام يقوم قم. قام يقوم قم. قائم داش قيام. قائم داش قيام. And that is what you studied in the إقامة part. قد قامت الصلاة. So this were these were the words for قَالَ, examples. قَالَ ذَاقَ تَابَ كَانَ قَامَ. Let's go ahead with زَادَ. Now زَادَ is going to follow the ضَرَبَ pattern. ضَرَبَ يَضْرِبُ اِضْرِبْ ضَارِبْ مَضْرُوبْ ضَرْبْ. So it's going to follow the pattern of ضَرَبَ. So let's further break it down. زَادَ, the مَضِهِ. زاد زادوا زدت زدتوا زدتم زدنا. Then يزيد يزيد يزيدون. تزيد أزيد تزيدون نزيد. And then the أمر زد زدوا لا تزد لا تزيد. Then we have the noun part. زائد مزيد زيادة. So this mazid is going to be, inshallah, the topic of your grammar, mazid fi, inshallah, once you come up in course number 3. And the example is, Rabbi zidni ilma. So then we have another example which follows the same pattern, kada. So kada, he plotted. So let's practice it together. You can do it after me. كاد يكيد كد. كاد يكيد كد. كائد مكيد كيد. كائد مكيد كيد. And it comes in سورة الطارق. إنهم يكيدون كيدا وأكيد كيدا. So what they are doing, indeed they are planning and planning a plan, and I am planning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is planning a plan. So this was the example of Zada. So Zada, Kada is simply following the same pattern. So moving to Sha'a. Now Sha'a is actually following Sami'a pattern because the original word was Shayi'a. Shayi'a, it's same like Jayi'a. Khawifa. So it's following the same pattern. So for you, you just need to Remember, sha'a. So the examples, let's do the table directly. Sha'a, yasha'u, sha. Sha'a, yasha'u, sha. Sha'in, mashi'un, mashi'a. Sha'in, mashi'un, mashi'a. Insha'Allah, we use it a lot. Insha'Allah, if Allah wills. Khafa, he feared, following the same pattern. If you could repeat it after me. Khafa, yakhafu, khaf. Khafa, yakhafu, khaf. Khaif, makhuf, khawf. Khaif, makhuf, khawf. Fala khawfun alayhim, wala hum yahzanun. They will have no fear and they will not be grieved. So these were the three examples, three styles which we covered. So 9 verbs which occurred 3,600 times. So you see the importance of these verbs. And we have 130 such verbs that occur 5,300 times in the same style. So let's go ahead with the spoken part. So I'll be asking the questions and you'll be simply answering. So I'm just asking whether he repented. Did he repent? So you will answer, yes, he did. So it would be the one who is in front of you. So it would be, did you repent? So you will answer, yes, I did. I repented. So, هل توبت? نعم. توبت. هل توبتم? نعم. توبنا. هل تتوب? So answer it, please. نعم. أتوب. هل تتوبون? نعم. نتوب. So then the أمر, I'm just giving an order or a request. Tob. Atubu. So you'll be answering atubu. Tubu. Natubu. So similarly, going ahead, it would be, if you're giving an order to someone to stand up, so it would be kum. And he'll be answering akumu. Okay, I'll be standing up. Kumu. Nakum. So similarly, going for zada, hal zitta. Naam, zittu. Hal zittum. Naam, zidna. Hal tazidu. Naam, azidu. Hal taziduna. Naam, nazidu. And then the amr part, Zid, you'll be answering Azidu. Zidu, Nazidu. So finally, for Khafa, Hal Khifta, you'll be answering in negative, but just to make sure that for the Madi part, you will be using Ma, and for the Mudari', you'll be using La. Hal Khifta, Ma Khifta. هل خفتم ما خفنا هل تخافوا لا أخاف هل تخافون لا نخاف So then لا تخف So you'll be answering I won't be fearing لا أخاف لا تخافوا لا نخاف So that was all for the practice part. And inshallah, you can continue with Dr. Saab.
Jazakumullah khair, Brother Haroon. So let us go now for Kahoot. Where are we? Okay, so we are doing now grammar with page 5, pointer A. So grammar with 5A, and I'm sharing the screen. The number is 550663. 550663. 550663. Any question, our coordinators?
Ji, assalamu alaikum. One question is, why Adam al Islam is called Khalifa, whom he succeeded?
Yeah, I mentioned it already in the lecture that maybe there were some other creations before us on the earth, according to scholars, and we are saying like jinns or whoever, and that's why we are called Khalifa. Then Qalubi, they translated as they asked. Well, in the context as translators, you know, they use it. It's like just to maintain the flow and also the context, they say it, they ask, but qalu means they said, in principle. Is there any way to find the meaning of ma? As you said, it would be used either as not or what? Yes, depending on the context, you will understand it. So, and that context is there in every language also. You can find every language has words which have double meanings. Okay, so let us start now the quiz. Grammar with 5A. The first question is, three noun keys of zada are. Noun keys means fa'il, maf'ul, fa'il type. Is it Zada Yazid Uzid or Zaid Mazid Ziyada, Zada Yazid Uziyada or Zaid Mazid Zid? We are talking about noun keys, okay, not verb keys. It is Zaid Mazid Ziyada. Now, some people have taken I would say Zaid Mazid Zid. Zaid Mazid is okay, but Zid is a verb. Okay, Zid is a verb, so it's not a noun. So Zaid Mazid Ziyada. All right, so let us go to the next one. Three verb keys of qala. Verb keys means like fa'ala, yaf'alu, yaf'al. So what will be for qala? Is it qail maqul qul, qala yaqulu qawl, qail maqul qawl, qala yaqulu qul? We are talking of verb keys, not noun keys now, this time. Three verb keys of qala are qala yaqulu qul. Okay, these are verb keys, mashallah. Majority got it right, so let us move on to the next one. Yatubuna, translate Yatubuna. Yatubuna. They repented, I repent, you all repented, they will repent. Yatubuna means they will repent. They repent or they will repent. So we gave you only they will repent, so that is the one. They repented will be, maadi will be, taba, tabu, is all past tense. Faalu, amilu, qalu, tabu, amilu. Okay. All right. Let's go to the next one now. Translation of shi'tum. Shi'tum. You all willed, you will, he wills, they willed. Now, will is a verb here, okay? To want something. You all want it, you want, he wants, they want it. That is will, okay? Shi'tum. You all willed, you all wanted. That is shi'tum, okay? And you will means tasha'u, okay? That is present tense, but we are shi'tum, fa'altum. This is maadi. You are willed. Sha'a, sha'u, shi'ta, shi'tu, shi'tum. Shi'tum, you all wanted. Shi'na, we wanted. All right, let's go to the next one now. Translate into Arabic, we stand. Is it taquna, aqumu, naqumu, qumna? We stand. This is present tense, okay? So make sure you translate it right. We stand something here. What is it? We always start with na, naqumu, na'budu, nasta'inu, naqumu. Okay, so naqumu means we stand. Qumna is past tense. Qumna, okay, we stand, this is we stood, okay? So please be clear. Qumna, let's say, where is Qumna? We, this is we stood. This is we stood, that is Qumna, okay? Naqumu means we stand. Naqumu is we stand. All right, so let's go to the next one. Hal tatubu ila Allah? Do you repent to Allah? Or do you turn to Allah? Do you repent? Actually, it means. So you should say, yes, we repent to Allah. So is it na'am, na'am tatubuna, tubtu, natubu, atubu? Tatubu is singular. Hal tatubu, do you turn to Allah? So you should say, na'am, I turn to Allah. Tatubu, atubu. Tafalu, afalu. Okay? Tafalu, afalu. Now, many people said, natubu ilallah. Natubu is plural. If we had said, hal tatubuna, so you will say, na'am, natubu. So let us do some practice so that you are clear about this when it comes to weak words. So, hal taquluna, do you all say? What will be your answer? Naam, naqulu. Just take the last noon and put it here. I hope you got the point there. Taquluna, mashallah, it is not leaking, alhamdulillah. So, taquluna, it is ending with noon. So take this noon here and say naqulu. Okay, taquluna naqulu, taf'aluna naf'alu. Okay, taj'aluna naj'alu, ta'kuluna na'kulu, tatubuna natubu. So again, answer me. Hal taquluna? Na'am, naqulu. Hal tatubuna? Na'am, natubu. Hal taziduna? Na'am, nazidu. Okay, hal takiduna? Are you plotting? Na'am, nakidu. Hal takununa? Are you going to become something? Na'am, nakunu. Yes, we will be. Nakunu salihin. We will be good people. Okay, nakunu sadiqin. We will be truthful people. So, hal takununa? Na'am, nakunu. So, we have zada, kana, qala, all those taquluna, taziduna. So it will be naqulu, nakunu, nazid, nakunu, and so on. All right. And then we go to the next question now. Hal qulta khayran? Be careful. This is fa'il madi. Did you say good? Hal qulta khayran? So the answer is na'am qala khayran, qultu, taqulu, aqulu. Now you must be at a level to distinguish between madi and mudari. Okay? Hal qulta khayran? So na'am qultu khayran. Very good. Majority got it right. Na'am qultu khayran. Only 8 people said aqulu. Ta will be tu. A'u ta'tu tumna. Ta. Tu, qulta, qultu, fa'alta, fa'altu, nasarta, nasartu, right? Zitta, zittu. So let us practice this ta'tu, fi'il madhi, so you don't lose. Hal, let us say, wahabta, I'm going to the weak verbs, okay? Hal wahabta, did you give? Na'am?
Na'am,
wahabtu. Okay? Hal wa'atta?
Na'am,
wa'attu. Hal wajatta?
Na'am,
wajattu. Hal قلت
نعم
قلت هل كنت
نعم
كنت were you there for example هل كنت هناك نعم كنت هناك yes I was there هل زدت
نعم
زدت right so تا will become تو and تكون أكون the beginnings will become تا will become آ here يا ta'ana. All right. Yaqulu, yaquluna, taqulu, aqulu, taquluna, naqulu. All right. Let's take the next one now. Eighth question. Hal hum khaifun? Are they afraid? Maybe the kuffar on the day of judgment. Hal hum khaifun? Naam. Hum khaifun? Huwa khaif? Nahnu khaifun? Antum khaifun? I'm asking about them. So talk about them. Don't bring others. I'm saying, are they afraid? So you should be saying, yes, they are afraid. Naam, hum khaifun. Very good. Yes, they are afraid. Okay, we're talking about them. I said, are they afraid? So you should say, yes, they are afraid. Okay, now let's take another one. Zidni ilma. Translate. A very simple question. Zidni ilma. Increase him in knowledge or us or me or them. Increase who? Him, us, me, them. Zidni, ni means me. Rabbi, zidni ilma. O Rab, increase me in knowledge. And don't forget to ask this dua, you know, as much as possible, especially after salawat or whatever, whenever. But as an anchor to remember, we said Ayatul Kursi mentions ilm twice. So remember that ilm and ask Allah for knowledge. Increase me, zidni. If it is us, by the way, some people said, increase us in knowledge. What will be increase us? Zid, increase na, as zidna ilma. If you want to say increase us in knowledge, you should say zidna ilma. So suppose you are praying together you're sitting together and praying. So you say Rabbana zidna ilma. Okay, the singular was Rabbi zidni ilma. So remember when you are asked to pray. So if you are praying for yourself, Rabbi, this is actually short form of Rabbi. Okay, Rabbi, oh my Rabb, zidni, increase me. So ni is for me, Rabbi is for me. If it is plural, it will be Rabbana. So Rabbana, our Rabb. So if you are sitting with others, Rabbana, zidna, increase us, ilma, in knowledge. All right, let's go to the next one. So I'm writing actually like that. Wala khawfun alayhim. Translate. Wala khawfun alayhim. Wala khawfun alayhim. Okay. I think I by mistake pressed a button trying to adjust my board. No space here. Sorry. Wala khawfun alayhim means and there will be no fear on them. On them. La khawfun, no fear. What means and alayhim, on them. Sorry about that. I wanted to write better. But anyway. So let us take another one. Oh, sorry. We have reached the end. So here are the results. Sister Zainas, Brother Irfan, and we have topper, Sister Raksha, and then we have the other two, Sister Sharina, and someone dreaming good. That's nice. So view full report now. Let's see the others, players. Okay, so here are next five, mashallah, 100%, that's good. And another 10, many of them 100%. And then we have, that was 30, and this is 40, and this is 50. Congratulations, and then we go now to the next lesson, which is about Adam alayhi salam, continuing. Remember, we are on the fifth page. And the fifth page, the pointers are very simple. What are they? Can you repeat it three times? Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, Tawbah. Khalifa, Asma, Sajda, So we talked about Khalifa, the question on Khalifa. Now we will talk about Asma, meaning names. So Allah is talking about teaching of names. So here we are. Where are we? In the second pointer. So this is the second pointer, teaching of names. So in the previous verses, Allah mentioned the question to question of angels. The angel said, why are you creating somebody who will spread corruption and shed blood? And by the way, this is the question that is raised by many people who are atheists or who are away from any religion or even away from Islam. They'll say, oh, if Allah is alive, then what is he doing now? So many people are killed and so much oppression is going on. What is he doing? This is a standard question. This was asked, this question was mentioned, is mentioned in the Quran, was asked by angels even before Adam alayhi salam was created. Okay? So for Muslims, it is not a new question. If we know the Quran, we will know the answer. Okay, as simple as that. So this is not something, and the atheists presented as if they got a big proof that Allah doesn't exist. Astaghfirullah. No, they are nonsense, stupid actually. Allah says, "Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun," and He answers the question here. Think about it seriously. Ponder the verses, and you will find the answer. And I strongly recommend you to go to YouTube. Okay, very strongly recommend you. In fact, this is one of the best programs on YouTube. This is by Dr. Jeffrey Lang, and I'm showing you. You will really, really enjoy it. Jeffrey Lang was a Christian professor, atheist actually, from University of Kansas. And here he is. This is an advertisement. And let us skip the advertisement. And I think I'm Norwegian. Okay. So this is professor. He's professor of mathematics. He was professor of mathematics. I don't know if he's still there in the university. He's alive, I think, alhamdulillah. I met him also. Dr. Jeffrey Lang was a professor of mathematics in the University of Kansas. And he was an atheist. Didn't care about religion. And he became Muslim. And he studied this page of the Quran. See, we just go over the pages of Quran just like that. And he studied and studied and studied and thought about it, and he got all the answers that he had. And if you read, if you listen to his lecture, you will be amazed with the depth of his understanding and the way to ponder the Quran, way to think, way to do tadabbur, how subhanAllah every verse guided him to the truth. You will be amazed, amazed. And you will also be amazed at the verses of the Quran talking about so many details which we just pass over. We just, وَقَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ يَزُونَ and we still say, where is the answer? It is there. It is there. And look at this professor, subhanAllah, he found the answer. And I strongly, to increase your iman and to know how to learn how to think, how to ponder, how to think over the verses of the Quran, please listen to this lecture. It is an eye-opening lecture on the creation and the answer to bloodshed. Okay, the answer to bloodshed, because he was one of those atheists who used to say, where is God? What is he doing? Why there is so much oppression? What's going on? And so on. So in these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah taught Adam the names, and we can say subhanAllah if you don't know the answer. Angels realize that human beings will have knowledge and therefore do other things, good things too, and Allah knows ghaib of everything. Now, the new words are very few, as I always I keep skipping, but if you watch the video, it is there. So new words on this line are 20212. So there are only 6-7 words in these 5 lines. Okay. So and even some of them you already know. So let us see in this one. You know Allama, you know Adam, you know Asma, you know Kullaha, Kul. Okay. Thumma aradahum. This may be new to you. Okay. Then he presented them. You know Ala and Malaika, Faqala, Ambi'uni. This is new to you. That's all. Ambi'uni means inform me. So let us see. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. So I'm going to go fast because this is a big big, I would say, selection. Three verses. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا And he, means Allah, taught Adam alayhi salam the names, all of them. He taught all the names. ثُمَّ عَرَضَهُمْ عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَةِ ثُمَّ means then. عَرَضَهُمْ He showed them, he presented them. What? The names or the objects, sorry, عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَةِ To the angels. فَقَالَ And said, Allah said, أَنْبِئُونِي بِأَسْمَاءِ هَؤُلَاءِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ أَنْبِئُونِي means inform me. أَنْبَ means news. نَبَأٌ news. نَبِيٌ Nabi Adam alayhi salam was Nabi. Nabi means prophet, the one who gives news. Okay? News from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is related. Okay? So, أَنْبِئُونِي inform me. Tell me about what? Asma'i ha'ulai, the names of all these objects or people or whoever. In kuntum, if you are sadiqeen, truthful. So all words are known to you. In kuntum occurs in the Quran many, many times. So in kuntum means if you are. Just remember this phrase. In kuntum, if you are. In kuntum sadiqeen, if you are truthful. So we covered this. So the new words are thumma aradahum. Ambiuni are two new words. Okay. Aradahum presented them. Okay. Showed them. Ambiuni informed me. So let's move forward now. Clear drawings. I have to switch the mode and then it will move forward. Okay. So, Thumma aradahum in kuntum sadiqin. Then what did the angel say? Qalu. سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ They said, all words are known to you, except عَلَّمْتَنَا عَلَّمَ See, عَلَّمْتَنَا عَلَّمْتَ عَلَّمَ means he taught. الرَّحْمَنُ عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَ عَلَّمَ means taught, right? عَلَّمَ عَلَّمُ عَلَّمْتَ عَلَّمْتَ you taught. نَا as you taught us. عَلَّمْتَ نَا you taught us. Okay, عَلَّمْتَ نَا You taught us. So let us take the words. عَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ I hope you know عَلِيمُ is from عِلْمُ and حَكِيمُ is from حِكْمَةُ Knowledge. Oh, sorry, wisdom. So let us go word by word. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا قَالُوا They said, سُبْحَانَكَ Exalted are you. Glorified are you, meaning you are free from defects. Actually, this exalt, glorify, do not give the full meanings. So just remember, Subhanaka means free from defects. Oh Allah, you are free from defects. So they said, Subhanaka, you are free from defects. La ilma lana, no knowledge for you. La ilma means there is no knowledge. La ilaha illallah, there is no God except Allah. La ilma. There is no knowledge lana for us illa except ma allamtana what you have taught us. Okay, innaka antal alimul hakim. Alim innaka you, anta you, it means you alone. Innaka anta. Indeed you are the all-knowing, alim, full of knowledge. Al-hakim, the wise, full of wisdom. All right, so here we get a lesson. If we don't know something, so extremely important lesson we get from these verses to follow the example of angels and say, Subhanallah, if we don't know anything. So what did the angels say? They said, Subhanaka, because Allah was right in front of them. And we, when we talk to each other, somebody asks, we can say, Subhanallah. That means only Allah is free from defects. I am having defects. I am not having perfect knowledge. Okay, that's kind of one message. So the last verse is, and here also the new words are only, you should not be scared about so many words. Amba'a, you know. Ambi'uni, we learned ambi'uni. Ambi'u means inform. Ambi'u, inform. Singular is ambi, inform. Okay. It is request or order. Amba'a, he informed. And this is like advanced forms that you will know in the next course. Don't skip the next course. As I said, every line has one mazid fi on the average. So here you see ambihum, amba'ahum, and also tubduna. This is from mazid fi. Mazid fi means these extra verbs. Extra letters are there in the words. Naba'a, amba'a. So it is derived form. Allama. Alima, he knew. Allama, he taught. He made someone know. Okay, allama. Anyway, so ambi is singular. Ambi'u is plural. So can you repeat it three times? Ambi, ambi'u. Ambi, ambi'u. Ambi, ambi'u. Ambi, ambi'u. So Allah is saying, قَالَ يَا آدَمُ أَنْبِئْهُمْ بِأَسْمَائِهِمْ قَالَ He said, يَا آدَمْ O Adam, أَنْبِئْ Inform هُمْ Them who? The malaika. About what? أَسْمَائِهِمْ Of their names. Those objects or people, whoever they were, said, okay, inform them of their names. فَلَمَّا فَ means so, then, لَمَّا when, لَمَّا may be new word, sorry. لَمَّا is when. So when, Amba'ahum, Amba'a, he informed hum, them, the angels, the asma'ihim, the names, qala, that Allah said, alam aqul, did I not say, lakum, to you all, inni, indeed I, a'lamu, I know, ghayba samawati wal arz, the unseen of the heavens and the earth, wa a'lamu, and I know, ma, what, Tubduna, this is new word, you reveal, you show, whatever you are showing, Tubduna, wama kuntum, and what you were, taktumun, hiding. Now what were they hiding? Tubduna, they said it, and you listen to Jeffrey Lang and you'll enjoy it, Dr. Jeffrey Lang. A'lamu ma tubduna, whatever you were revealing, showing. What were they showing? They showed only one aspect of Adam, which is the children of Adam, that they will spread bloodshed. وَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْتُمُونَ And what you were hiding. Well, that may not be intentional, but they knew the positives also. But it is like the shopkeeper, you know, presents it in front of you. And there is a black spot on the white shirt. So will you point toward? Will you? First thing you will say is, what is this black spot doing here? Okay. So something similar happened to perhaps angels. So they said, oh Allah, are you creating somebody who will be spreading mischief and bloodshed? But they knew, perhaps, ma kuntum taktumun, that he will be good also. That's why Allah said, wa a'lamu ma tubduna wa ma kuntum taktumun. Now, what are the names of these? What were those objects? There are different sayings of the scholars. One of the saying also is that they were, good people were shown to them. Wonderful people who will praise Allah, who will dedicate their lives for Allah, who will spread the word of Allah, who will spread peace and prosperity, who will sacrifice themselves to bring the goodness and prosperity for others. So they are excellent people who will, in spite of all those life struggles and tests, they will never forget Allah. They will thank Allah. They will always be praising Allah. So those were the people that were shown to Adam alayhi salam and also to the angels. This is one interpretation. There are others also. So I think you know the meanings now. Let us go to the asma and afal. I just want to skip the other parts because we don't have time. And I do encourage you to watch that YouTube clip. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salam the names. And we can say subhanAllah if we don't know the answer. And angels realize that human beings will have the knowledge and therefore do the right things, other things also. And Allah knows the ghaib of everything. And ultimately, this was a test. So And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is creating these human beings for test. So if Allah, as atheists and people say, what is Allah doing when there is so much bloodshed going on, so much oppression is going on? Well, everything is passing through test. And Qiyamah is going to come, and he will give the, he will award the good people and punish the bad, and he will establish justice. He is Hakim and Alim. All right. So we can say, oh Allah, increase me in knowledge and help me worship you sincerely, and help me remember that there is wisdom behind everything. Why is Corona happening? What is going on? Well, Allah knows. All right. Asma and Af'al, plural of Ism is Asma. Okay, Malak is Malaika, and Ghaib is Ghuyub. We have too many names. Sama is Samawat, and Ard is Radi. So can you give me the plurals? And all of these are broken plurals, okay? They are not following these un-in patterns. Can you give me the plurals? Ism,
Asma,
Malak, Malaika, Ghaib, Ghuyub, Sama, Samawat, Ard, Aradi. And the verbs are aradahum, aradahum. Can you show me the TPI? Aradahum, aradahum. Arada, he presented, he showed whom, them, the angels. Sorry, whom, the objects. Alal malaika, on the angels. So let us go to the six forms. Arada ya'ridu, i'rid. Arada
ya'ridu,
i'rid. Arid, ma'ruz, ard. Arid, ma'ruz, ard. Okay, ard is also called exhibition in Arab world. Whenever there is exhibition, there is, they called it ard. Ma'raz. Ma'raz is a place. Ma'raz is exhibition. So it's related to presentation. All right, sadiqeen. Can you show the sign, TPI sign? Sadiqeen, sadiqeen, those who are truthful. So what is he said the truth? Sadaqa. We say sadaqa Allahul Azim. Allah said the truth. So repeat. Sadaqa yasduqu usduq.
Sadaqa yasduqu usduq.
Sadiq masduq sidq.
Sadiq masduq sidq.
Taktumun. Show the TPI sign. Taktumun, you hide. So what is he hid? Katama. Repeat. Katama yaktumu uktum.
Katama yaktumu uktum.
Katim maktum kitman.
Katim, maktum,
kitman. All right. And ghaib is from weak letters. Ghaib. Show the sign. Ghaib. Ghaib, unseen. So he was unseen. He disappeared. Means ghaba. Repeat. Ghaba yaghibu ghib.
Ghaba yaghibu
ghib. Ghaib. Maghib. Ghaib. Ghaib. Maghib. Ghaib, we know ghaib, ghaibun, ghaibin. It is coming in the Quran also. All right, so without wasting any more time, let's go to Kahoot. And we are doing not grammar, we are doing right now page 5, pointer B. So here is the Kahoot pin, which is 830026.
Assalamu alaikum. There is one question.
Yes.
Does this mean angel have already seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
I think you can ask it to scholars, but the dialogue is going on and they are addressing Allah directly. So seen, not seen, not seen. You can ask the scholars. Okay, so next, can you please help with the complete table of tilawa? Tala, okay. Yes, tala, yatlu, utlu. Talin, matlu, tilawa. Tala, yatlu, utlu. Talin, matlu, tilawa. Why there are mad at certain places? Well, this is has to do with tajweed rules, and you can follow our tajweed course. It is available on the website. And you will know how and why mad are used. All right, so let us start the quiz now. 830026. 830026. Arada hum. Translate. Arada hum. He showed them or... Come on, he showed them. There are two. He showed me, he showed us. He showed him, he showed them, me and us. Him, them, me, us. Arada hum. So basically, what is the meaning of hum? Hum is he showed them. Okay. Sorry, I read first one wrongly. It was my mistake. Second is ambi'uni. Translate. Inform him, them, me, or us. Ambi'uni. Ni, you know, Rabbi Zid ni, ambi'u ni. Okay. Allahumma ja'al ni min at-tawabin after wudu. Ni, ni, ni means me. So, ambi'u, all of you inform ni, me. Ambi'u ni, inform me. All right. Ambi'hum. Inform them, him, me, or us. Ambi'hum. So we are asking the meaning of hum in this case. You know, ambi means inform. And we already learned ambi, ambi'u, singular and plural. Ambi, inform, hum, them. Mashallah. Very good. Okay, let's go to the next question. Translate bi asma'ihim. Oh, you know him, asma. And their names, of his name, of your name, of our names, and of their names. Inform ambi'hum them bi asma'ihim. Is it? And their names, or of his name, of our names, of their names. Of their names. It's not and. Bi does not mean and. It means of in this context. See, inform, you know, as the English, as per English. Sorry about that. This button is very sensitive. So, okay. So, ambi'hum. Let us see the construction and then you will know. So, ambi'hum. Ambi'hum. So, ambi'hum. Inform them bi asma'ihim. Bi is of their names. So bi asma'ihim will be of their names. If it is wa asma'ihim means and their names. Okay. Wa asma'ihim will be and their names. Okay. Because 32 people got it wrong. So I said, what's the problem? Okay, next one. فعل مضارع of كتما. Now we learned تكتمون. So كتما, what is this one? This is it كاتم, يكتم, اكتم, or كتما? كتما, he hid. What is he hides? That is, or he will hide. That is يكتم. كتما يكتم. Okay, and that is تكتم. Taktumu, aktumu, taktumun. You all hide. And kuntum taktumun. You remember that? I hope. Kana yaktumu. He was hiding. Kanu yaktumun. They were hiding. Kunta taktumu. You were hiding. Kuntu aktumu. Kuntum taktumun. You were hiding. So don't forget that. Kuntum taktumun. It's made up of two words. Three verb keys of sadaqa. Verb keys like fa'ala, fa'alu, ifa'al. So what is for sadaqa? Is it sadaqa yasduqu usduq? Sadiq masduq sidq. Sadaqa yasduqu sidq. Sadiq masduq sadaqa. Verb keys. Madi, mudari, and amr. Sadaqa yasduqu usduq. Okay. many people fell into this trap. Sadaqa, yasduqu. Yes, these are verbs, but sidq is noun, to say the truth or truth. Sidq. It's not verb. Usduq is a verb. Usduq, be truthful or say the truth. Plural of ghaib. Is it ghaibun, ghaibin, ghuyub, or ghaibat? All kinds of messed up things. Plural of ghaib is ghuyub. Inna rabbaka yaqdibfu bilhaqi allamul ghuyub. Allah's name is allamul ghuyub. He knows all the unseen. All right. Allah taught Adam alayhi salam about what? Names, angels, jinns, none of these, according to this verse. He taught them the names. Allama Adam al-Asma. MashaAllah. Next one. Before presenting to angels, Allah taught Adam Tawbah, the names, the books, good manners. It's a similar question, but in a different context. Well, kind of same context. So he taught him the names again. Okay, not Tawbah. Tawbah is in the end. Okay, before presenting to angels. Okay. All right. We can say ... if we don't know the answer. What can we say? Is it Alhamdulillah, Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah? We don't know the answer. We say Subhanallah, because we are taught by angels here. Qalu subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. All right, I think we have reached the end, and here are the toppers. Sister Shakila. I don't know if Zan is brother or sister. That's a new name for me, Sister Armina. And Brother Abdul something, and Sister Sharina. And here are the toppers, more toppers. So view full report, 81% did it right. That's very good. And here we are with the players. See, there's first 10, next 10, and another 10, 30, 40. Everybody got 100%. That's good. And 50. Congratulations. And Brother Abdul Rahim, are you ready now?
There is one question. Can you take now or later? Okay.
Brother Abdul Rahim, you can be ready and I answer the question.
How did the angel know before they have seen a human that they will spread blood?
We said it in the beginning, in the first lesson of today, 5A, we said it, that Quran does not mention all the details. Okay, it mentions only specific things that are relevant to us. And here, Allah should have leaked this information. Allah may have leaked this information, and Adam alayhi salam's kind of statue was there. And as some of the scholars write, angels were going around, and Iblis also saw it. So all this happened, and you will see Iblis got jealous. So this information was leaked, given to them. Okay, leaked or given to them. And that's why they asked the question. All right, so Allahu Alam. So Brother Abdul Rahim, please go ahead.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala ashraf al-anbiya'i wal mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters, once again, I, Abdurrahim Naimuddin, welcome you all for the grammar session. Today's lesson is 5B. Inshallah, in this, we will see some weak letter verbs, inshallah. And the revision to da'a and hada and dhanna and dhalla, inshallah. First of all, let us have the quick recap of what we learned. The sound verbs, fataha. If you open Quran, fataha, Allah will help you, nasara, or else it will be hit, baraba. So it's better we listen to Allah Azza wa Jal. Then wahaba, Allah will give you, it's his promise. Wa'ada, we have weak letter verb in the first letter. Then qala, Allah said, zada, he will give, in fact, more. In qala, we have weak letter verb in the center of the verb. And in zada also, the red color shows that this is the weak letter verb there. And therefore, pray to Allah, da'a, we have the weak letter verb in the last letter as the weak letter verb. And hada, as you can see, the ya in red color, hada, that to pray to Allah that he gives us the guidance. And dhalla, think good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, dhalla, you will get lost. Sound verbs in the Quran are almost 9,000 times, subhanAllah. 9,000 times is almost every line of Quran contains one sound verb. And the weak letter verbs are also 9,000 times in the Quran, subhanAllah. 9,000 times. And double letter verbs are 1,300 times approximately. So make sure that you memorize full table of each one thoroughly, because numerous repetition. When Allah said Quran is easy, it's subhanAllah, very easy, subhanAllah. But it's not automatic. So if you open Quran, fataha, Allah will nasara, or else you will be hit, daraba. So it's better we listen, sami'a. Allah will give you, it's his promise, wahaba, wa'ada. Wahaba, wa'ada. Allah will give you, it's his promise. And it is said by Allah, qala, in fact, he said, he will give more. Qala, zada, qala, zada. Therefore, pray to him for guidance. Da'a, hada, da'a, hada. And have good opinion, otherwise you will be lost. Dhanna, or else you will be dhalla. Dhanna is to have good opinion, and dhalla is to get lost, like we saw in Ghayril Maghdubi Alayhim Waladdallin. Keep smiling to get the reward from Allah Azza wa Jal. So we will see da'a. Okay, da'a, we see this last letter, we have a weak letter verb here, da'a. So da'a, yad'u, ud'u, and da'in, mad'u, du'a. The first one, we will have the complete cycle. But if you know this, the first verb, da'a, then rest all will be easy for you. Da'a, da'a, da'aw, da'awta, da'awtu, da'awtum, da'awna. Yad'u, once you know yad'u, rest all are easy. Yad'u, yad'una, tad'u, ad'u, tad'una, nad'u. Okay? Once we know, this is the kickstart, this is the key, master key. Once we know this, rest all are easy. Then, ud'u, once you know this, rest all are easy. Ud'u, ud'u. La tad'u, la tad'u, da'in, the one who calls upon, da'in, mad'u, the one who is called, mad'u, and du'a, is to call. Like Allah said, wad'u shuhada'akum min dunillah, you know, call upon your witnesses apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll practice the six forms just to have ease in our practice. Da'a, yad'u, ud'u. Da'a, yad'u, ud'u. Da'in, mad'u, du'a. Da'in, mad'u, du'a. The next verb is tala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْرُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. Indeed, those who recite from the kitab of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Tala is to recite. So, tala, yatlu, utlu. Tala, yatlu, utlu. تالين متلو تلاوة تالين متلو تلاوة. Many times we hear تلاوة القرآن, recitation of the Quran. Then we have خلا, like we saw in the Quran, وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ, you know, when they are alone with the leaders, with their shayateen companions. خَلَا, so he was alone. خَلَا يَخْلُو أُخْلُو قَالٍ dash خُلُو. Once again, خَلَا يَخْلُو أُخْلُو خَلَا يَخْلُو أُخْلُو خَالٍ dash خُلُو خَالٍ dash خُلُو. Okay, keep smiling. So we, now we'll practice Hada. Hada, you see the last letter is the weak letter here. Hada. Hada is he guided. Like we saw this in course one in Surah Al-Fatiha, Ihdina Surat Al-Mustaqim, guide us to the straight path. So Hada is he guided, Yahdi, he guides. Okay. Let us see the complete table first. Hada is he guided. Hadaw, they guided. Hada, Hadaw, Hadaita, Hadaitu, Hadaitum, Hadaina, Yahdi, he guides. Yahdi, Yahduna, Tahdi, Ahdi, Tahduna, Nahdi, Ihdi, Ihdu, like here, Ihdi, Ihdi, Na, guide us. Okay, this word imperative, Amr, it becomes request as well in the context. So here the word is imperative, but it is astaghfirullah, as if we are begging Allah Azza wa Jal to guide us to the straight path. Okay. Ihdi, ihdu, la tahdi, la tahdu, hadin. Okay. Next three important keys, nouns. Hadin, the one who guides. Hadin, mahdi, hidayah, or huda. Now let us take the six forms for this. These are the master keys, three verbs and three nouns. Hada, yahdi, ihdi. Hada, yahdi, ihdi. Hadin, mahdi, hidayah. Hadin, mahdi, hidayah. Then we have jaza. Many a times we come across, we say jazakallahu khairan, may Allah reward you. Okay, jaza is to reward. Okay, jaza, he rewarded. Jaza, jaza, yajzi, ijzi. Jaza, yajzi, ijzi. Jazin, majzi, jaza. Jazin, majzi, jaza. Once again, jaza, yajzi, ijzi. Jazin, majzi, jaza. Like the example, jazakallahu khayran, may Allah reward you. Then we have jara. Jara is to flow, like we see Jannatin tajri min tahti al-anhaar. There in the Jannah, we will be having, you know, rivers flowing beneath. Tajri min tahti al-anhaar. So jara. Jara, yajri, ijri. Jara, yajri, ijri. Jarin, dash, jarayan. Jarin, dash, jarayan. Once again. Jara, yajri, ijri. Jarin dash jarayan. Like an example, jannatin tajri min tahti al-anhaar. Then we have ata, he came. Fa'atu bi suratin. Allah said, so, you know, bring surah bi mithlihi. Bring any one surah like of Quran, Allah said. Ata. Ata ya'ti iti. Ata ya'ti iti atin. As you know, this two hamza get merged and there is a mad here, atin. So the sound is two alif sound. Atin, atin, ma'ti, itiyan. Once again, ata, ya'ti, iti. Ata, ya'ti, iti, atin, ma'ti, itiyan. Atin, ma'ti, itiyan. Like in the example, fa'tu bi suratin min mithlihi. Then we have Masha. Kullama adaa lahum mashaw fihi. Okay? To walk. And as in Hajj and Umrah, we see many Arabs say, imshi, imshi, imshi. Then walk, walk, don't stop, walk, walk. Because if you stop, the way will be blocked. So imshi, imshi, imshi. So masha is he walked. Come on. Masha, yamshi, imshi. Masha, yamshi, imshi. Mashin dash mashi. Mashin dash mashi. Masha, yamshi, imshi. Mashin dash mashi. MashaAllah. So you have practiced almost 8 verbs that occur 900 times in the Quran. MashaAllah. So in the Quran, we have approximately 100 such verbs which are repeated 2,300 times. SubhanAllah. Once again, here it's a clear proof when Allah said Quran is easy. So indeed, it's easy. SubhanAllah. Keep smiling to get the reward. MashaAllah. So first column is the sound verbs. Then we have the weak letter verbs. And weak double letter verbs are almost 1,200 times in the Quran. Vanna. Zanna is he thought or he thinks. Vanna. So vanna yadunnu dunna. Let us have the first one complete table. Then others will have the important 6 forms. Vanna, vannu, vananta, vanantu, vanantum, vananna. Yadunnu, yadunnuna, tadunnu, adunnu. تظنون نظن ظن ظنوا لا تظن لا تظنوا ظن مظنون ظن. Okay, now let us have the 6 to A's, just for the A's, isness in the practice. 6 important forms, 3 verbs and 3 nouns. ظن يظن ظن ظن يظن ظن Van madhnoon van. Van madhnoon van. Now let us have the next verb, radda. Okay, the example is inna radduhu ilayka. In the context, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the mother of the Musa alayhi salam, indeed we will return Musa alayhi salam to you. Radda. Radda yaruddu. Rudda, radda, yaruddu, rudda, rad, mardood, rad, rad, mardood, rad, radda, yaruddu, rudda, rad, mardood, rad. Then we have madda. Yamudhum fi tughya. Mad is to stretch. In tajweed we see madd muttasil, madd munfasil, attached madd and detached madd. Madd means to stretch. Madd. Madd. Madd yamuddu mudda. Madd yamuddu mudda. Madd mamdood madd. Madd mamdood madd. Keep smiling to get the reward. MashaAllah. Then we have double letter verb dhalla. Dhalla is he went astray. Okay? Like we saw wala dhallin and nor of those who go astray. Dhalla. Dhalla. Dhalla is he went astray. Dhalla, dhallu, dhalalta, dhalaltu, dhalaltum, dhalalna. Yadillu, yadilluna, tadillu, adillu, tadilluna, nadillu. Dhilla, dhillu, la tadilla, la tadillu. Dal, the one who goes astray, and the plural daluna or dalina, like in Surah Al-Fatiha. But a dalin, dalun or dalin, those who go astray, those who went astray. Dal dash dalalah. Let us practice the important forms. Dalla yadillu dilla. Dalla yadillu dilla. Dal dash dalalah. Dal dash dalalah, like in the example wala dhallin. Then we have kharra. Okay, kharra to fell. Kharra, kharra yakhirru khirra. Kharra yakhirru khirra. Khar dash khar. خار داش خر خر يخر خر خار داش خر Then we have حق okay? Like وتواصوا بالحق They advise each other to the truth حق يحق حق حق يحق حق حقيقة داش حق حقيقة داش حق حق يهب حق حقيقة داش حق MashaAllah, you have practiced six verbs that occur 525 times in the Quran. SubhanAllah, approximately 900 verbs, MashaAllah, which are repeated 1,350 times. SubhanAllah, all of them on just Walla and Wanna styles, double letter verbs. So make sure you learn all these styles thoroughly. You don't miss the homework, inshallah. Keep smiling to earn the reward. Let us take some spoken Arabic dialogues. Hal talawta al-Qur'an. Tala is to recite, as we saw. Hal talawta al-Qur'an. Did you recite the Qur'an? So the answer will be, Na'am talawtu al-Qur'ana. Did you recite Qur'an? Yes, I recited Qur'an. Na'am talawtu al-Qur'ana. Hal talawtum al-Qur'ana. Did you all recite Qur'an? Na'am talawna al-Qur'ana. Yes, we all recited Qur'an. Hal talu al-Qur'ana in the present tense now. Okay.
We'll answer. We will answer. You ask the questions.
Okay. هل تتلو القرآن؟
نعم أتلو القرآن.
ما شاء الله. هل تتلون القرآن؟
نعم نتلو القرآن.
ما شاء الله. أتلو القرآن.
أتلو القرآن.
ما شاء الله. أتلو القرآن.
نتلو القرآن.
نعم نتلو القرآن. Yes, we all will recite Quran. Okay, mashallah. Let us go to the next one.
You are frozen. Okay, no problem. So we are running out of time. So inshallah, that's hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue with the kahoot now. Please take the kahoot number. So I'm going to Jazakallah khair, Brother Abdul Rahim. So we'll continue. So the kahoot number is 716-103. And as we have seen in the repetitions taught by Brother Harun and Brother Abdul Rahim, you have seen we are learning nothing new. We are just making you strong in the six keys. Okay, once you're strong in the six keys and of course the extension, you know all of it. And the next course will be very, very, very easy, easier than second course. I told you second course is easier than first course because all you are doing is just learning the weak verbs. Okay, wa'ada qala. So wa'ada wahaba qala zada. Hada and Da'a and Dalla and Dhanna, which are repeated root letters. That was the contents of the grammar part of the second course. All right. So now let us move to the quiz part 716103. So I'm starting 716103. 716103, the first question is three noun keys of dhanna. Noun keys. Fa'il, maf'ul, fa'il. That style, okay? Is it dhanna yadhunnu dhan? Dhan madhnun yadhun? Dhanna yadhunnu dhun? Dhan madhnun dhan? Noun keys, okay? It is dhan, madhnoon, dhan. Okay, and dhan has two meanings, okay? One is to assume, to conjecture, do conjecture, guess, and another is to have strong faith. Depends on the context, you will know it. Okay, three verb keys of dhalla. Verb keys of dhalla. Verb keys are like fa'ala, yaf'alu, if'al. Is it dal dash dalala? ضل يظل ظل ضل يظل ضلالة ضال مضلول ظل verb keys of ضل. It is ضل يظل ظل ضل يظل ظل. Okay, let's go to the next one. Translate yad'una. 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 They will call upon. Yad'una, they will call upon. Okay. All right, let's go to the next one. Translate talawta. Talawta. It's from tilawa, okay? Looks strange, but talawta is you recited, you recite, you will recite, we recite. Talawta. It's like fa'alta. Talawta. Now there is confusion, okay, huge confusion. Why is that confusion there? You see, talawta is you recited fa'alta. The endings are changing, so talawta. But the ta is there, so I think maybe you got confused. Tala, this is yatlu, yatlu, yatluna, tatlu. Tatlu means you recite. So tatlu, there's a double ta there, okay? The first ta is tatlu means you recite. So this ta is for you, and the second ta is part of the root word and root of the verb. So tala, yatlu, yatluna. Tatlu, you recite. Atlu, I recite. But talawta is tala, talaw, talawta. You recited. I hope now the confusion is clear because of those so many tatas. Okay. Translate into Arabic. They come. Is it? Ataw, yati, yatuna. Ta'tuna, they come. This occurs in the Quran a lot, I mean the ata. So ata, ya'ti, he comes, plural is ya'tuna. Ya'ti, ya'tuna. Yahdi, yahduna. Okay. Yaqdi, yaqduna. So e plural is una. Yahdi, yahduna. Okay. So please don't be confused here. Ya'ti, he comes. Ya'tuna, they come. And you have to really learn this ata. And next is ata. They are a little confusing if you are not practicing. Hal tad'u Allah, do you call upon Allah? So you should say, yes, I call upon Allah. Is it nad'u Allah, ad'u, da'awtu, da'a? Hal tad'u Allah, do you call upon Allah? So you should say, yes, I call upon Allah. So I, is it nad'u, ad'u, da'awtu, da'a? Ad'u, very good. Ad'u Allah. I call upon Allah. Da'awtu is I called upon. Nad'u is plural. We call upon. Hal yajzikumullahu khayran. Does yajzi reward you all, Allah? Does Allah reward you good? Or he will reward, will he reward you good? So you should say yes. Allah will reward us. Will reward us. Okay. So is it jazana, jazahum, yajzikum, yajzina? Yajzi, he will reward na, us. And who is that? Allahu. I mean, the subject comes later on in Arabic in this arrangement. So, yajzi, he will reward na us. He will reward us. Yajzikum, does he reward you? Good. So you say, yes, he rewards us. Yajzi na. Jazana, jaza is past tense. I was asking you about future. Okay, you are saying about past. Jazana, he rewarded us. That is past tense. We are talking about future. Yajzina, he will reward us. All right. Hal al kafiruna dallun, are the kafirs lost? So you should say naam huwa dallun or hum dallu, hum dallun huwa dalla. Yes, you should say yes, they are lost. So what is that? Is it huwa dal, hum dallu, hum dallun, or huwa dalla? Naam hum dallun. Yes, they are lost. Hum dallu is also correct, but it is not close to the question because we are saying dallun. So you should say dallun in answer. Dallu is like past tense. That is a verb. Our question was based on noun. Translate. Wa yamuddu hum. We told you mad is like وَمَلَائِكَ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ. So mad, you know what is mad now. وَيَمُدُّهُمْ. مَدَّ يَمُدُّ. So what is وَيَمُدُّهُمْ? And he prolongs him, them, you or them. Wa is and. يَمُدُّ, he prolongs, he extends, he stretches. هُمْ, them. So blue is right. MashaAllah. Last question, yatluna kitab Allahi. Is it you recite or they recited? I will recite, they recite. Yatluna kitab Allah, the book of Allah. Who is reciting? Is it you or they or I or they recite? They, yatluna. They recited blue. Some people took blue. Oh, sorry. I took the wrong thing. Anyway, yatluna, they recite. Talaw, they recited. All right. So here are the toppers. Sister Rakshan, Sister Sharina, and Sister Zaina. And then we have two more who are Yusha and Saba. I don't know. Yusha, maybe brother. Yes, Yusha bin Noon. Assistant of Musa alayhi salam when he visited Khidr alayhi salam, as per some scholars. Okay, that was the name of him. Okay, so here are the first 10, the next 10, and the next 10, and the next 10. So congratulations, and then I am leaving this another 5 minutes for questions.
One question, there is just the student asking for the pattern whether in verb, sir, verb have ya in mid word and noun have mean in mid word. So can we practice like this?
Yeah, I don't know. Which, can you give me an example? You can type right now. I don't see any verb having ya in the mid word, I mean, as a pattern.
Yeah, they are asking, not saying a pattern, but they are saying that we can practice like this, that ya in the middle is a verb and meme in the middle is noun.
I don't know which verbs have meme in the middle, the nouns. This is difficult to say. No, I don't think this is the right approach. What you can see is u, ta, tu, tumna. These are the endings for fa'al madi. And ya, ya, ta, a, ta, na, these are the beginnings for fa'il mudare. So you can remember that. And nouns will have on the pattern of fa'il, maf'ul, fa'il for the time being. Okay. So maf'ul only has mim in the beginning. Only maf'ul. Is there any easy way to find the meaning of ma? It is only through the context. Okay. Only through the context you will know it. Just like any other language, you know, only context will tell you what does that word mean. And I had some nice English words, but I don't have it off my mind, where English words give you opposite meanings, but depending on the context.
Okay. So we have Muhammad Amhar, brother.
Okay, you can ask. You can allow people to ask on the mic.
Brother Muhammad Amhar, you're allowed to talk. You can just unmute your mic and you can speak.
Assalamu alaikum, doctor.
Walaikum assalam.
My question is, we are asking in the daily dua, Rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira.
Yes.
So when we ask as a group, do we say Rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayana saghira, or should we continue as?
Okay, as a group. First of all, when you are addressing Allah, so our Rabb, what will you say for our Rabb? Rabbana.
Rabbana. Yes.
Irham, have mercy on them. So only not my mother and father. So all of us. So Rabbirham hum. And kama Rabbayani saghira. So Rabbaya means two of them. So it will plural be Rabbaw. Kama rabbawna sigaran. Sigaran plural is sigaran. So many plurals are there. Rabbana irhamhum kama rabbawna sigaran. Okay, next question.
Now we have Sister Yamina. Sister Yamina, you have the access to unmute your mic.
Assalamu alaikum.
There
are questions. The first question is that what's the difference between falamma and faida?
Okay. Well, these are finer differences as of now. And I also like to go deeper into that. I'd like to know more.